Problems in construction happen every day. This video is going to explain to you what makes problems in construction different from the problems you find in regular business. Hi, my name is Chris Conkle, and this channel is all about helping you master construction so that you can be an industry leader. Welcome back, Quality Crew, and if you're new to Chris Conkle Vlogs, make sure you guys subscribe and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss a thing. Today's video, we are going to be defining problems, like problem solving for construction, problems in construction, and how they're different from regular types of business. So just as project managers encounter different types of crews, like different crews, different personalities on every job, and different environments, work environments on every single job, the problems that arise during a project are also different on every single job. Each problem needs to be solved immediately and correctly. Any delays in problem solving can result in work delays. The problems that arise during the construction process are the main contributor to project delays and unwanted or unwarranted costs. The problems encountered on a construction project are or can be very complex and include several trades or subcontractors and suppliers. So project managers need to very carefully analyze each problem and come up with a solution that is going to have the least amount of negative impact on the schedule and the cost of the project. Some of the things that need to be recognized when problem solving would be, like, number one, the full impact on the subcontractors, suppliers, and prime contractor. Number two would be the cost impact and who is going to pay for any additional indirect or direct cost associated with this particular problem. Three would be the time impact. So how much extra time may be needed to added onto the schedule, right? So time change, how much extra time is needed to complete this task or to solve this problem. Number four is the best solution for the project conditions, meaning the crews, the work environments, the progress of the project, those type of things, right? The customer needs. All right, number five is the best method for solving conflicts between participants in the construction progress as quickly as possible. All of my videos, I talk about different problem solving techniques, and with each video I put out, I'm always talking about different problem solving techniques, because problems happen every day. New things happen every single day of our work. So it's important to be a good problem solver. Problems arise every single day. So the best managers and the best workers are the ones who can recognize problems on the fly and quickly solve these things. You don't always have to go and ask management or your supervisor to do something, certain things, right? If you know the right way, the way it's supposed to be, you can just go ahead and as long as you're building things to specification and drawing or the correct code and using the right technique and the right material, then you're always going to be okay. So what I mean by this also is, there's a lot of times when you're a journey person and you're in the field and you're working with an apprentice or whatever, and the drawings don't make sense, but you know, you've done it 100 times how to do this particular thing. It's just that the designers had missed something in their design, and this happens quite frequently, honestly. So a good journey person and a good worker is going to just recognize the problem right away and know what to do and just automatically apply it, so there's no delay in the contract progress, right? Or there's no additional cost to the contract. Now, when we start going into getting clarifications, what we call clarifications and change orders, well, that is when the delay in schedule and the costs start increasing for the project. So what happens is, in design phase, during the tender phase, a good estimator and a good project manager will be able to see a lot of these errors in the drawings and specifications at that time and submit clarifications to the designers. This is why the tender process is a very sacred thing. And a lot of contractors don't participate in this, what I'm about to talk to, unless like they're the big guys who, you know, the leaders, the good guys, right? Like Ellis Dunn or PCL or Ledcor, those type of companies, you know, they'll get involved with the designers during the tender phase, right? So a project will go out for a proposal before tender, and different trades will price parts of that project, right? And during that phase, then yeah, there is also clarifications and changes. But during the tender process, all a bunch of different trades get their eyes on the contract documents, which are the drawings and specifications. And this is why it's important to train managers from the field, from their first day all the way to when they join the office, because they can recognize the processes, the materials, and the techniques used to build the certain parts of the project. So when you got all these eyes on it, they're submitting, you know, clarifications. And then clarifications can come back as addendums, right? So what addendums are essentially changes to the contract documents. So addendum is a change order, like it changes something in the contract documents. And addendums then become a part of the contract documents, right? So it's a process. So it goes from clarification, requesting a clarification, so an RFI, request for information, on the on that certain subject, whatever the problem is, and the designers will send back what's called an addendum. And the addendum will, if indeed the question was warranted and and not easily explained, if it was just an error on the person who submitted the RFI, the designers will put out just an information type of addendum, right? So that it's a clarification, right? So sometimes the materials and processes, when they need to be changed, there's impact on cost or schedule, then a change order, an RFI, all that needs to be done. So problems are, they happen all the day. Every day there's problems in construction, and it can get very stressful at times, right? So the more workers that we have out there helping us solve problems, are, you know, we need to start working closer together, obviously, right, in the field. So the more workers we have out there who can recognize these problems and become problem solvers and leaders, the better the entire industry is going to be for it. Alright, so now we know why problems in construction are different from problems in other types of business. Alright, quality crew, well, we made it through another video. If you're new to Chris Kalko Vlogs, make sure you subscribe right down here, and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss a thing. My live stream every Sunday morning, you'll be notified of that if you hit that bell. So we don't want to miss that. I'm just starting to live stream, and I've done two. My third one is coming right up, and I'm very excited for that. Okay, so YouTube thinks you guys might like this video right here, so give it a shot, and let me know what you think by hitting that like button. All right, this is Chris. Bye for now.